Hello and welcome to VW Surf Wagon, where today we've got something a bit different for you. So myself, Sam and our good friend Lewis really enjoy a bit of hiking. We quite often go up to the Lake District and do some hill walking and stuff. And last year we did our first long distance hike where we did the West Highland Way, which we absolutely loved. We did wild camping every night. We took everything with us on our back. It was quite challenging, I'll be honest. It was a bit more challenging than I expected, but it was great fun. And basically, we wanted to do something similar again this year, but something a bit more remote, something a bit less popular, because we did obviously encounter quite a lot of other people on the West Island Way. So we discovered the Southern Upland Way, which goes from coast to coast in the south of Scotland. It's actually like way longer than the West Highland Way, so we thought we'd aim to do about half of the Southern Upland Way, maybe a little bit less, start in Port Patrick on the west coast, and head inland towards Galloway Forest Park, and a little bit further, and aim for about 5 days of hiking. So we hopped in Sam's van, drove up the M5 and M6, headed up to Dumfries, got a bus to Port Patrick, and we started our hike there.
They'll be able to like recommend you what.
Yes,
mate.
How's it going?
You know, it's feeling good. I'm feeling pretty good. I mean, I was thinking I might burn through my no hair.
Do you want some sun cream, mate?
I just lather it. It's like hair gel, but it's like creamy.
Could be. How's it been, Sam?
Ready to go.
Nice.
Let's do it.
We started our adventure by heading north along the coast path from Port Patrick. I know this spiraling storm cloud above my head has a lining, but I'm stuck in heavy fog. We then started heading east inland and quickly found ourselves on moors and in windmill farms.
So day one, we worked really hard. We did 16k and walked into town to get brewskis because it was hard work, man.
It was.
Cheers to that, big pumps. Mwah.
After a cheeky detour into town to get a pizza and a well-earned pint, we found a great camp spot in the woods and set up the tents. We managed 22 kilometers on our first day, which, considering we started at about 2 p.m, we thought wasn't bad at all.
How's everyone feeling?
Feeling all right.
On
feeling
day good. Two.
I'm feeling positive, you know. My are little you? Tootsies are in little good toe formation, totally.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Just, it's better than last time.
I see how it is.
Yeah.
On day two, we were in good spirits and we were aiming to hit at least 30 kilometres. The route took us through more moors, some really cute little forests, and obviously we had to make a slight detour to have a pub lunch.
They've all got roasts. I've got deep fried frickin' cauliflower.
All I wanna do is turn the car. It got to around 7 p.m. and we were in a really big pine plantation and wind farm. What we were noticing is that there were really no spots to camp. It was either really dense pine wood or bog. So what we decided to do was stop for a while, cook some food, and then carry on into the night. And this is when things went a little bit wrong. We carried on walking until at around 10 p.m. we made it to a place called Polbay, where it looked like there might be a little spot to camp, but the midges were insane and we panicked a little bit and just kept walking. We kept walking until we had done almost 40 kilometers, where eventually we found somewhere to camp after asking a landowner's permission. The next morning, the midgy situation was even worse. And considering it was Lewis's birthday, we decided to admit defeat, admit that we had done it at the wrong time of year, and head to somewhere we know and love, the Lake District. Unfortunately, I didn't get that much footage from the Lake District because we were having such a good time, but we did go on a little boat tour of Derwent Water. And we also did a really fun hike over Scarfell and Scarfell Pike via Lord's Rake, which was a bit of a scramble. So we ended up having a great week in the end, but sadly, the Southern Upland Way is yet to be conquered. Maybe we'll come back when there's fewer midges.